drive 5 minutes in any direction and find themselves out in the middle of the desert. It was incredible. They created new visions based on light, space, form.
Perhaps the biggest star from this period was Richard Diebenkorn, who would become one of America's best late 20th century painters. His reputation was already rising when he entered the UNM's master's program in 1950. While some might consider Albuquerque a mere stopover on his journey into the art stratosphere, it was not the case. He and his paintings were never the same after Albuquerque. Biographer Mark Lavatelli told the Albuquerque Journal in 2007. Here was a new freedom for him. Diebenkorn lived on a ranch just west of Old Town. Lavatelli said Diebenkorn picked up inspiration everywhere, from the cattle and horses outside his door, to arroyos and mesas, even aerial views of the land. Things really started to come together for me there. It was a very good situation for me, because there was none of this fear of painting, Diebenkorn told interviewer James Shovel in 1957. But not everyone appreciated Diebenkorn's talents. When Diebenkorn presented his abstract expressionist graduate show in 1952, UNM's conservative faculty failed him.
So Johnson threatens to quit.